Welcome to India Construction Week 2020, an event organized by Construction Industry Development Council and Indian Society for Trenchless Technology. The theme of this event is Reviving Construction Industry in the Post-COVID World. I am Umesh Dhargalkar, a consulting engineer from Mumbai, and I am here to give you a glimpse of how COVID-19 has affected the very, very common redevelopment projects in Mumbai, such projects which are unique to the city of Mumbai, the kind of challenges which are being faced and what could be the way forward. So first, let us understand what is redevelopment. Well, this is an urban renewal model where open or vacant plots of land are scarce in a city. Like say, in a city of Mumbai, in the heart of the city, presently, there are practically no vacant plots where new buildings can come up, whereas the city is still growing. Okay, so if the new homes or new commercial spaces have to be constructed in the city of Mumbai, there is just no space available. So this model will allow such new homes and commercial units to be constructed by a method wherein an existing building is demolished and a new building is being constructed. So why is redevelopment important in the city of Mumbai? First and foremost, because many of the buildings which were constructed maybe 30 years, 40 years, 50 years back in the city of Mumbai have now become old, and they are in need of frequent and expensive repairs. There are many buildings still in Mumbai, the old buildings, wherein there are no elevators, or I would say no good playing area, no proper parking space. So the amenities are not up to the present requirement. So in this model, what is done is that an existing building in the same plot, which is owned by many times, you know, quite often owned by cooperative housing societies, the existing buildings are demolished and new buildings are constructed as per the present development control regulations. Now, present development control regulations allow more area to be constructed on the same plot. So today we construct more area, whereas the existing the area which is consumed in the existing building is much lesser. So there is a difference. So we get to construct some more area. So what happens is that a part of that new area which is being constructed, okay, comes to the benefit of these existing members of the cooperative housing societies in form of a bigger flat, and the remaining carpet area is sold in the open market, you know, so as to fund the project. So its difference in the floor space index or FSI that drives this such a project. Now on the face of it, it looks like, you know, this is the easiest way. If you already have a plot of land, it's very easy that you demolish the building and you construct a new building on that. You take the help of a developer to do that. It appears to be an easier way to get a new and bigger home with modern amenities without spending your own money. But in reality, such projects are hugely complex and there's a lot of uncertainty into that. This model is definitely a popular model in cooperative housing societies in Mumbai, simply because there are no open plots available. And such cooperative housing societies, as you may be knowing, that they are owned by families. So we look at a cooperative housing society as a family of family, as a one large family who undertakes this project because they collectively own that land and they invite a developer to come and do the project. Typically such projects are long duration projects. So minimum I can think of is something like 3 years. So the project can be 3 to 5 years duration, conduct is quite complex. It starts with the project feasibility, then tendering, then the approvals, then the contract with the developer, and finally the concession, and then the people move back. And until that time, when the building is being constructed, the original owners of the plot, they have to stay in a rental accommodation. This is a relatively new concept in Mumbai. This has been in practice for something like 10 years. And in that sense, I would say, in addition to being complex, this actually takes you into an uncharted territory. There is something which is, the model is still not, I would say, matured to make it, you know, a kind of a model which can be easily followed by everyone. So this has, such projects do have their pros and cons, and they are quite sensitive to policies and market conditions. Policies which allow them to construct additional area, policies which charge them some approval costs, policies which put some restrictions in the, you know, in the sale of those flats, the market conditions, how the revenue would be generated, how the revenue would be used, how the revenue would be apportioned in form of the requirements of RERA. These are the typical challenges which are faced by such redevelopment projects. And I must say that such projects are definitely full of risks, uncertainties, and challenges. You know, anything can go wrong in those 5 years, and many times many things go wrong in those 5 years. In that sense, we have to be ready for sudden change in those policies. Otherwise, we will have what we call as pitfalls and failures. Now, as I said, redevelopment has its own challenges, right? But even with those challenges are nothing as compared to what we are facing today, the challenge of COVID-19, which has not only affected the city of Mumbai, it has affected everyone globally. And particularly the real estate market has been significantly affected. And even in the real estate market, the redevelopment projects which are implemented by the owners of the plots themselves are also very significantly affected by COVID-19 situation. Let's see in what manner COVID-19 has impacted such projects. First and foremost, we have to understand that such projects are actually driven by the sales. You know, the revenue is something which makes these projects go on, right? And what's happened in COVID-19 pandemic situation is that the sales have been sluggish and restrained. Well, people always wanted to buy flats because housing is the basic need. But in reality, the sales were not happening. People were waiting. People were waiting for the better policies to emerge. And suddenly the pandemic struck, and then, that's what they had to face. Reduced demand for commercial units. You are aware that the pandemic situation has made a significant change in the working culture, where people are now started working from home. A lot of things are happening from home today. Even many of the purchases are done by ordering them from websites like Amazon and Flipkart. So the demand for commercial units, you know, a lot of companies have now relinquished their offices, and they have already finalized the plans for migrating to the work from home culture. So this has definitely affected the commercial units, the offices, and to some extent the shops and showrooms. Okay. Then reduced selling rates. So developers had to, you know, come down and reduce their selling rate just to make the need for the working capital. Because if you have to sustain the project for 3 to 4 to 5 years, naturally you need the working capital. And earlier in the pandemic situation, the working capital was not coming, because of which the developers had to reduce the selling rate, thereby affecting their financial viability of a redevelopment project as a business prospect. Approvals became really, really slow in Mumbai, especially, and particularly for redevelopment projects. There is a huge requirement of approvals. Sometimes 40 to 50 permissions are required, and they are being granted by different approving authorities. The local municipal corporation is the biggest approving authority, and there are other authorities as well. So because of this, you know, work not happening, people not reporting to office, and because such offices had their own way of, you know, working culture, they could not easily adjust to the new situation, as a result of which the approvals came in very, very slow. Then, due to this threat to life, a lot of laborers, they ran away to their own native places, and labor was hard to find. So even when recently, when the laborers have started coming back, the cost of transportation, okay, and the cost of maintaining them on the site under those new stipulations of COVID-19 adds to a significant cost there. So the labor costs have definitely gone up by 15% or so. Well, there is on the brighter side of it, the rental costs, which, you know, the rents for the people who are staying outside, the owners who would be staying outside for during the construction period. Thankfully, the rental costs have gone down, and the stamp duty and ready reckoner rates also have reduced to some extent, thereby marginally increasing the demand for the flats, homes. But these kind of, you know, the benefits are very, very marginal as compared with the impact, the negative impact which COVID-19 has actually made on such projects. Increased marketing costs. Since the sales are not happening, extra cost has to be paid, extra brokerage has to be paid, because concessions have to be given, or huge marketing has to be. So marketing cost has gone up significantly. Marketing cost has gone up by my reckoning by about, say, 25%. Then there is a higher contingency cost. Well, in such projects, there was a practice of, you know, making a provision for contingency costs. But contingency was really not taken that seriously earlier. But this COVID-19 has really made people sit up and take note of that, and contingency for the first time has become a real cost for the project. For the first time, developers who were earlier used to concentrate on the total net profit and were not really so much concerned about, you know, the duration of the project, for them suddenly cash flow has become more important than the net profit, because they have to sustain the project during the construction period, all during the project period, and with due compliance to real estate regulatory authorities of the city of Mumbai or of the state of Maharashtra. So for that purpose, to keep the project moving, the cash flow became took the center stage, become more important than the net profit. Decision paralysis and fear psychosis at the society. You know, societies which are actually the owners of the plot. Suddenly, pandemic has changed their perception of looking at their own life and again the life of the project. This has also significantly affected the project. And for those new projects, which were about to be launched or which were about to be, you know, initiated, you know, they suddenly came to a standstill because the response from the developers, the response from the market, and the uncertainties of the policies and the market, it became so overbearing that the new projects actually had to wait for a much longer time. And what happens in the existing projects? The projects were already existing. They have now suffered a delay of something like 6 months already. Okay. And not just that, the costs have gone up, okay, the period has been extended, and because of all these things, the profitability of a developer, the rates, the selling rates have gone down. Because of that, the profitability of the developer has been significantly affected, and as a result of which, many developers are coming back to the societies, asking to renegotiate their commercial offer so that the project can be made viable. And there is a rise to the commercial disputes again because of increasing cost, because of the delay which has set in. So the disputes are on the rise. Now with that, now we need to see, now how can we face these challenges? Is there a way to deal with these effects? Well, the answer is yes and no. We can do something about it, but more and what needs to be done is mainly at the policy levels. So something needs to be done to encourage these redevelopment projects by special policies or by special incentives. Now, first and foremost, what needs to be done is that the cost of construction permits needs to be reduced. Okay, typically redevelopment projects has three types of costs: cost of construction permits, cost of construction, and all remaining costs. Now, these three costs are, you can say, equal in the sense each of them is one third of the total. So what can be done is that the cost of construction permits needs to be reduced, and for that what needs to be done is that the ready reckoner rates, which actually jack up the total cost in every sense, if we need that rate needs to be the rates of the properties across the city, they need to be reduced further. Okay, now when the ready reckoner rates are reduced, automatically many of the approval costs are also reduced. So that is what needs to be done. And in addition to that, the municipal premiums which are paid to the municipal corporation also need to be reduced significantly, so as to bring the cost of construction permits to a lower level. Then some financial facilities should also be good for such projects. And what we can look for in such facilities is that first is deferment of premiums, so that the developer gets the much needed working capital. Okay, the premiums whichever the corporation or the approving authorities are charging, they should be deferred. More time should be given to the developer so that the working capital gets released and that can be used into the construction of the project. Then project specific loans and advances is something which, you know, project financing in construction projects was something which was not happening for a long time. And with this pandemic situation, when the money is not coming, a lot of projects are stuck because of that. So what is required is a policy wherein, you know, loans and advances can be given to specific projects depending on its merits, and reduction in interest rates on home loans and stamp duty. This would be something which will help the buyer or encourage the buyer, motivate the buyer to buy flats, and thereby once the sales are happening, when the revenue is coming in, the projects will definitely gain the momentum which they need. And then there are other policies. There is a model of self-development that is happening in the city of Mumbai, wherein people, the owners of the plot themselves, do the project without involving a developer. So what is required is better and easier policies and softer loans or easier loans for such projects, so that the projects can be done at a lesser cost. Faster construction permits are always have always been, you know, the kind of high on the wish list, and then the faster dispute resolution method, so that people get over their disputes and move with the projects and come back in their own homes as soon as possible. So thank you very much for your time. For those of you who have any questions or who would like to have more information about such projects, you can get in touch with me on this phone number or on the email ID which has been given here, which is technosisacademy@gmail.com, and our website is www.technosis.co.in. Thank you very much.